Hello. So here I am in the midst of Adriatic Sea, practicing my circular breathing. And they come and they want to know some tips and tricks for our professional didgeridoo players. As always, when I'm swimming, they do that. So I was thinking a little bit what to say, and I had two ideas that might help professionals, but they might be good ideas also for people who are not professional. So what I see is that when we are young didgeridoo players, we want to impress others. So we go for different tricks and different sounds, and we try to play as fast as possible. And little by little our ambitions grows, and we think, maybe I can become a professional. And here I feel that we lose a bit of overview of what is going on and what a professional musician needs to deliver. So one of the two things that most players who are learning fast are missing is the sound. Like, it's very basic quality of sound that you deliver, that when you hit the bass has the punch. When you play a trumpet tone, it is clear and precise. When you are in any kind of articulation, that articulation is executed very well, very clearly. And I feel to achieve this quality, you need to come back to basics and practice. For example, what I gave to myself to practice, when I was practicing air code, I took just one basic sound, like a drum. This is what I explained in some other videos, and I will make some more videos about it. This basic drum, and just making 10 perfect ones, you know, with all 10 sound the same. It's actually quite boring if you don't devote your attention to it, but if you do devote your attention, then it becomes exciting, because it's quite hard to get 10 perfect ones. You can also take the other air chord sound, the air chord, as an example to get this clear, clear small sounds, and that you can direct them in a fine detail and so on. Another example can be to take takawaka and practice it for 2 hours in a row, 3 hours in a row, 4 hours in a row, and just focus on perfection of it. So this is one thing, and the other missing link that I found is are the compositions. And it takes quite a lot of time to make good compositions. You have to have a good idea. Then you have 5 other ideas that you don't want to die. You don't want them to die, but they have to, in order for that one idea to thrive. And it takes a lot of work, in a way, which is not as simple as just coming to the didgeridoo and you just play. You know, you have to think a little bit, you have to decide, and decisions are hard, and you have to start from a good idea usually. And so to make nice, original, powerful, diverse compositions, it all takes time. And what is kind of paradoxical is that actually these two sides are connected, in the fact that many ideas that came to me were actually a product of exercising something very basic. So I would do 1 hour of doom tap, doom tap, doom tap, doom tap, doom tap, and kind of the brain goes into kind of hypnotized state, out of which it just has to break free. And when it does, it usually comes up with something, you know. When I say it comes up, actually the idea itself comes as breaking out of this cage. So if you devote a little time to practicing basic exercises and not changing them, actually you might solve 2 problems with just one approach. And this is good news for professional players wannabes, because now you know what you need to practice. But it's also good news, I feel, for people who don't have any aspirations to become professionals, because now you can also know that playing tricks and playing fast is the easy part, and it's maybe the most fun part. So if you want to get it, go get it. It's easier to play fast, complex articulation than it is to have perfect slow beats. Trust me on that one. In any way, go practice, and I will still stay here practicing my circular breathing a little bit. I heard that this is a good exercise, and so I have a little bit of material here. So thank you and bye bye.